Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to Zilta Force 2. We are continuing with the independent scenario quick missions. The next mission at hand is Mission Posse, which takes place early in the morning. Well, comparatively early, depends on who's talking about it. But yeah, early in the morning, 8:30 in North Africa. And the weather comprises of clear skies. The scenario is quite simple. A rebel munitions train is nearing a camp just beyond the border. Disable the locomotive and secure the train before it can cross the border. Now, here's the question that I have right now. Does it want me to hijack the train back from the terrorists, or does it want me to like take the train out? Because I don't know whether the first alternative is actually even possible or not. But let's look at the mission briefing then.
A munitions train held by anti-separatist rebels is making its way to a camp just beyond the border. The train is transporting large amounts of munitions and supplies designed to quell activist movements. You are ordered to disable the locomotive and secure the train. Alpha and Bravo teams will be inserted west of the tracks. Bravo will place Satchel Charges to disable the locomotive. Charlie team will approach from the south and converge on the train. Once the train is stopped, eliminate all hostile forces. We do not have authorization to cross the border. If the border troops are provoked, they will return fire.
Understood. Now, here's the thing. I can already see like two entire jobs. My god, I think that's the train? Or I hope that's not an enemy convoy. I think that is the train. So, it looks like we need to intercept the train using like a bunch of satchel charges. Just like pop in some satchel charges and wait for the train to just blow up, like arrive and then blow it up. And that is essentially what this mission is. Now, I can see lots of buildings here and neutral vehicles, not our vehicles, not the enemy vehicles, but just neutral vehicles that we need to take care of. I don't think we need to take care of them, but they're just there for whatever reason. Yeah, I think those are the border troops that the lady at the briefing was talking about, and border troops here. However, we do have two enemy choppers that we need to be aware of. I don't know whether this is like just a BRDM or a tank, or this is an actual chopper as well, but this is most definitely a chopper, because that's how far they usually come from. I don't know where I am. I think I would be deployed right here. There are also like three fire teams for our support in this mission. So yeah, let's see how it goes. Changing the gear. No, here's the thing. I think M4 grenade would be a better option, I think. And I would rather take a law, because I think like one saddle charge or two at most should be enough for the train. So with that in mind, I'm torn between taking the saw and the grenade launcher, the M4 with the grenade launcher. So honestly in a bind here. I think I'll just I'll take the grenade launcher. It should come in handy to clear out the train as well later. Anyhow, let's go ahead and begin this mission then.
Bravo, this is King 6. Intercept the munitions train before it reaches the border.
Okay, two folks here. It's a really time-sensitive mission, so should be another guy here, right there. Good thing I have burst mode on this rifle. Now we need to get to the train tracks and just plant the explosives there, and try to find a little bit of distance before we try and explode it.
You've got a large group of hostiles headed your way.
Roger, King 6. If it wasn't for these folks here, I probably could have maintained a little more stealth, but oh well. Things are out there. Can't really help it. Probably did not have to take him out, but this guy would have noticed me anyway, I suppose. I see some folks there. We will take them out, one by one. Well, perhaps starting with these guys over here. Okay. Engaging the enemy. Like, this is the only time that I can appreciate the burst fire mode. Is when you're in a rush. And you don't really have the time to be as accurate. I'm gonna just plant the explosives right here. And I'm gonna run back. Make a beeline right back.
This is King 6. Chopper inbound from the north.
Roger, King 6. Hauling us back to a safe distance. Hopefully the chopper will not be able to see me. If it is,
this
well,
is King 6. You have a second chopper inbound from the northwest.
Roger, King 6. This chopper mostly does not engage you, so we don't really need to take it out, as far as I've seen. The other chopper also does not seem to engage you as much either, so I think we are safe as far as the choppers are concerned. They just fly right over you, so you're more or less okay to not engage them. Like, the thing about choppers, right, unless they see you, they won't really, you know, engage you. And you can use that to your advantage if you're trying to blow them up. I'm just waiting for the train to arrive right now. And once it reaches around that spot, I'll blow it up. The train is here, so should the chopper be, but I'm not too bothered about the chopper, to be honest.
I have eyes on the target. You have shooters on top of the boxcars front and rear, and shooters on the flat cars with the heavy armor.
Bravo, this is King 6. Take out the locomotive.
Well, I'll need to take it out. The only way I can take it out is when it comes somewhere over there. So I'll just wait until that happens before I blow the fuse. The thing is, since I'm in the grass, it should be more difficult for the chopper to notice me, as is the case. Because that chopper would be a menace otherwise. Should be good enough. Yep, it is good enough. And since we are in the grass, not a lot of people can see us, which is ideal, just the way we want things to be. Hidden from most of the enemies. I don't know whether the chopper is going to keep running circles around us, but let's hope that it just flies away. Stops bothering us, I mean. Okay, should be more folks there. Can't see them. And that's honestly part of the problem.
This is King 6. Oh. Good work.
And that is it. That is honestly the mission. However, it did take me a few tries. It's a short mission, it's a sweet mission, and the choppers are more or less just a distraction. But at the same time, well, it is time sensitive, so you need to rush. You need a little bit of skill to actively aim at the enemy properly. That is Alpha 1. Look at them. They're also snaking around in the grass, just like me. No wonder the chopper didn't shoot at them. And the train has not crossed the border, which is a mission success. Alright then, we have commandeered the train and we are coming back. Over and out, Bravo. Sorry, King 6. And that was that for Mission Posse. Time-sensitive mission, that's really my only complaint with it. I mean, they put the quick in the quick mission here. pretty short, pretty fast, it's like a lightning strike, to be honest. Very surgical, very precise strike, but you have to also be pretty fast when you're performing it. So, yeah, it might take you a few tries just to get the layout of the land and try to figure out where the tracks are and how to optimally blow the train while trying to avoid the choppers. And that is what I did. And once you do that, it's actually pretty easy. Not that difficult, to be honest. Anyhow, the next time we come back, we will be covering Mission Playbook. But until then, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. See you next time. Take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.